Good morning and welcome to worship at St. Barnabas on this fourth Sunday in the season of Easter. If the windows were open on the memorial garden side of our worship space, you would smell that the goats are here. If you're joining us on Facebook Live, go ahead and put a comment in the comment section of Facebook Live, letting us know where you're worshiping from. Our opening hymn is on page 3 of your service bulletin or on your screen. Please stand as you're able for the cross.
Thank you.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Dios omnipotente, para quien todos los corazones están manifiestos, todos los deseos conocidos sin ningún secreto encubierto, purifica los pensamientos de nuestros corazones con la inspiración de tu Santo Espíritu, para que perfectamente te amemos y dignamente celebremos tu santo nombre. Por Cristo nuestro Señor. Amén. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, whose Son Jesus is the good shepherd of your people, grant that when we hear his voice, we may know him who calls us each by name and follow where he leads, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. Awe came upon everyone, because many wonders and signs were being done by the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their possessions and goods and distribute the proceeds to all, as any had need. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the goodwill of all the people. And day by day, the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, I
A reading from the first letter of Peter. It is a credit to you if, being aware of God, you endure pain while suffering unjustly. If you endure when you are beaten for doing wrong, what credit is that? But if you endure when you do right and suffer for it, you have God's approval. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example, so that you should follow in his steps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was abused, he did not return abused. When he suffered, he did not threaten, but he entrusted himself to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds, you've been healed, for you were going astray like sheep, but now you have returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers." Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Come, Holy Spirit, come and fill this place, and fill our homes, and fill our hearts. Amen. Before I start, some of you may not have recognized the goat reference that I did at the beginning. Once a year, we get a herd of goats here at St. Barnabas, and we have 80 to 100 goats out here today on Good Shepherd Sunday, but we have the goats out there. And you will have to go out and see them. It's a very wonderful setting to see, and you'll have to decide for yourself if they start to chomp in rhythm with one another or not. Today I start with Maya Angelou's poem, Alone. Lying, thinking. Last night, how to find my soul a home where water is not thirsty and bread loaf is not stone. I came up with one thing, and I don't believe I'm wrong, that nobody but nobody can make it out here alone. Alone, all alone, nobody but nobody can make it out here alone. Sometimes since COVID, it seems like we're more isolated than we were before the pandemic. God created us to be social creatures. We thrive when we are in healthy, loving relationships with others. So why are we feeling more and more alone? I dream of a world in which we are united again with one another. I can imagine a world in which we look with affection on our differences. I believe in a world in which we see God in all and around all. I dream of a world in which we see how extensive God's love is for all of creation and for all people. Today's gospel reading has Jesus using two related metaphors. In the first, Jesus is the shepherd who leads the sheep in and out of the gate. Jesus cares for the sheep, and the sheep identify with the shepherd. In the second metaphor in today's gospel reading, Jesus is the gate. Like a door, the gate controls who goes in and out. And for some, this means that Jesus is the great divider. Jesus divides the sheep from the goats. Jesus separates the wheat from the chaff. Jesus judges some as worthy and lets them in, and he judges others as unworthy and he keeps them out. For some, there is great comfort in having Jesus as the great divider. Jesus rewards those of us who do the right things and believe things properly, and he's the gate that keeps others out so that we can remain untainted by those dirty people. No, I'm one who does not see Jesus as this great divider. That view would go against my understanding of our triune God and my understanding of the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. Instead, for me, God is the great uniter, the ultimate connector. We have a God who created all and declared it all good. We have Christ, who is throughout the universe, is the perfect union of spirit and matter. We have the Holy Spirit, who connects all things in this universe and certainly connects all people. We have a God of unlimited grace and mercy, whose very nature is to love us unconditionally. In today's gospel reading, Jesus says, "I am the gate." He does not say, "I am the wall, the barrier, the enclosure, the dividing line." He does not say, "I am that which separates, isolates, segregates, and incarcerates." Instead, Jesus is the gate, the door, the opening, the passageway, the bridge. These are the places where freedom begins. Needless to say, most of us, left to ourselves, don't associate gates with freedom. We think of bars and locks and alarms and enclosures. We imagine toddler gates, or maybe puppy training gates, prison gates, and gated communities. But what if Jesus is a different type of gate, a gate that opens out instead of closing in? Not the barrier itself, but the aperture in it, a place of release, movement, spaciousness, and liberty. Jesus said, "I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and I will come in and go out and find pasture." Furthermore, when we look at Jesus as the great connector, we see a gate that is open to all. It is open to all, irrespective on whether a person has been good or bad. This is a gate that has qualities of mercy and grace. This is a gate which includes all, welcomes all, and invites all. Today, I want to invite you to let go of any notion of God as a divider and instead embrace the certainty that we have a God who unites. We are united to God and we are united to one another. This is a message of hope that is sorely needed in our world today. It's a message of reality that we can share with the world. We are all one with one another. Now, when we have Jesus as this gate of union, then we can look around and see that we have been gathered together with people who are all very different than we are. We often surround ourselves with people who are already like us, but Jesus calls us to reach out and be in union with the other. Jesus calls us to be connected to our enemies. During his lifetime, Jesus was constantly reaching out and connecting to the people around him. But sometimes we reject being united, especially when someone brings out the worst in us or we bring out the worst in them. In his book, The Great Divorce, C.S. Lewis tells the story of a busload of people who travel from hell to heaven. And some of the people who had the blessing of traveling up to heaven re-enter the bus to go back to hell again. One of the common reasons for leaving heaven is because some saw people in heaven they didn't want to be around. One person with an inflated ego is offended because she sees people in heaven she considers beneath her. Another leaves because he will no longer be able to dominate others in heaven. But the most common reason that people choose to leave heaven is because they see people there that have wounded them in life. Resentment and trauma can lead a person away from God because we can't stand that God would be connected to someone like that. We reject unity then with God and others because our wounds hurt so much. We mistakenly insist that God have as little use for that person as we do. Is it any wonder why Jesus taught so much about forgiveness and healing? Our false self and wounded ego causes us to reject unity with God and others and move back into separation and isolation. As I said earlier, sometimes we prefer a Jesus who is a gate that divides us. What part of your own history causes you to prefer division? Who would cause you to leave heaven and disconnect yourself from God? Who are the voices in your own life that lead to division? Can you silence those voices? Can you turn off the noise so that you can focus on unity instead? And as followers of Jesus, I want to suggest to you today that we should all be working to be united with all others, and not just those that are already like us or people that we like. Some may think that this unity is only possible in the next life, but Jesus tells us to be his hands and feet and voice so that godly things can happen in this world. I hope you can imagine a world in which we are all united to God and to others. As followers of Jesus, we must work against the dis-ease that we all have, that we all continue to feel after the depths of COVID, the fear of being around others, the uncertainty of what's going to happen in the future, the anxiety that hits so many of us. When we focus on the unity that we have through God, then we work against the dis-ease that is going to last so much longer than the coronavirus disease. Our churches have a special role to play. After all, the basis of the word religion is religio, which is Latin for religamented or reconnected, religio. We have a special calling in our churches to help people religament or reconnect. After all, the basis of spirituality is connection. Connection to God, other, self, and the rest of non-human creation. So in a time that has so many shrill voices, may we be light. May we mirror beauty back to others so that they may see themselves in our smiling eyes. May we drown out the noise with songs of unity. We have a God of unity. Embrace that unity with God and with each other.
Please stand as you are able. And now let us affirm the faith of the church as we say the Nicene Creed together. We believe in one God,
the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic.
Father, we pray for your holy and Catholic Church.
That we all be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others in our community. We pray for Alex and his family, Carol Martoni, Kathleen and Richard,
Carter, Senta, Caleb, Linda, R.C.,
and Vannevasser. And we pray for the repose of the soul for Barry Humphreys, Hedda Kleinfeld-Schnapp, and John Shannon. And from the intercession, from the bidding book, we pray for healing for Hernando. We pray for the repose of the soul of Herr Douglas, thanksgiving for Courtney Davis, healing for Vida Masser, healing for Christy and Megan Simon, repose of the soul of Daphne, repose of the soul of Thomas Russell, repose of the soul of Linda, healing Calzada Delgado and Ricardo Alfredo, and healing for Sarah Hagadash. And do we have anything from Facebook?
Bid your prayers for Fructuoso and his challenge with Alzheimer's. Bid your prayers for the repose of soul for Dorothy Meadows. And bid your prayers of comfort for the Meadows family.
That rejoicing in your whole creation, we may learn to serve you with gladness for the sake of him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
And now the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us share peace with one another.
Peace.
And if you're on Facebook Live, go ahead and put the word peace or some other appropriate word into the comments section of Facebook Live. Also, if you're on Facebook Live and you have a birthday or anniversary or other celebration, put that into the comment section as well. Please be seated for the announcements.
Good morning, I'm Sheila Miller and I'm your vestry on call today. And I want to start by thanking everybody who came out for the workday yesterday. It looks lovely and keep up the good work. And in that line of thinking, May 20th is the workday at the thrift shop, so get that on your calendar. Also would like to draw your attention to the board out front. We've got two items out there that you need to look at. First off, we've been having some trouble with water underneath the education wing. So the engineers have come out, they've looked at it, and they think a French drain is going to be the way to solve the issue. And I believe there's some schematics out there for you to look at. And then the other thing is in the far parking lot out there, you'll see a nasty looking old shed. That's going to be replaced with a shipping container. We've talked a little bit about maybe even putting a mural on it to make it attractive, and it'll be a nice way to keep all the things that we want to keep in there safe and dry and sound. Thank you.
Thank you. Last week we reintroduced sharing of the wine with a common cup. Wanted to just let you know once again that during our Eucharist, you'll come up and get the bread. You can go to either side and get an individual little bowl for your wine, or you can go to either side this week and drink from a common chalice as well. So both of those options are available to you this week. And the reason that we do both of them is drinking from the common cup really gets to that theme that I was talking about in the sermon about being connected and united with one another, while drinking from the individual bowls instead is a sign of hospitality for those that don't feel comfortable drinking from a common cup. This last week, you should have received a letter via email around Canterbury. Canterbury is our Episcopal chaplaincy to Cuesta and Cal Poly here in San Luis Obispo County. And that letter asked you to prayerfully consider making a donation to that Episcopal organization. After this worship session at 11:40 in this space, we are going to have an instructor come and train some of us on CPR and the use of the AED equipment in the back. We have 10 slots there. We have two open slots still. So if you'd like to stay for the class, we do have two open slots. There is no charge to you, and you would be certified for 2 years then in CPR and AED. So stay after if you, Caitlin, you have something going on next Sunday. What do you have going on?
My senior recital is coming up on May 7th at 3 p.m. It's like my big senior project. So just a concert with me. It's about an hour of music with intermission, and my accompanist is Paul Woodring.
Very good. And it's going to be in the music building up on the Cal Poly campus.
Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah. I have a poster. I don't know where
there are posters out there. And on Sundays, you can park for free in that large parking garage that's right there.
Yeah, the parking garage is free on Sundays.
Good. So next Sunday at 3 o'clock, some beautiful music. Any other announcements? Any birthdays, anniversaries, or other celebrations, Susan?
My son-in-law had his 40th birthday last Wednesday, and tomorrow my husband and I will be celebrating 13 years together in marriage.
Very good. And Susan, you weren't here last week because you were helping to lead a preaching class where someone next to you was certified as a licensed preacher. Who is certified as a licensed preacher now?
I'd like to present to you our licensed Todd Long.
Yay! Also from a diocesan standpoint, six of us were up in Salinas Friday and Saturday at the spring renewal. We did hear from the newish bishop of the Diocese of Oregon, Diana Akiyama, who was a wonderful speaker. She talked to us about the noise that we have in everyday life and how we break through that noise so that we can, as the sermon said, be united, connected, and in relationship with one another in beautiful ways. Birthdays, anniversaries, or other celebrations. Did I see a hand back there, Charmaine?
Are we going
not yet, no.
Okay. Brian and I, our anniversary,
44 years. Congratulations. Very good. Yes.
My cousin Linda's birthday.
Your Jeremy's what?
Linda.
Linda. Very good. Happy birthday. Any other? Yes, Linda. Very good. 37th anniversary. Good. Jeff, anything on Facebook Live? Nothing? Okay. We have a birthday prayer followed by an anniversary prayer there in the middle of page 10. We'll start with the birthday prayer. Praying together, gracious God, who made us in your own image, we thank you for life, love, and joy. Send your blessing upon these, your children, who have completed another year. Surround them with your grace, fill them with your love, and strengthen them to be your servants in the world. This we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And the anniversary prayer, saying together, we thank you, gracious God, for the love you have implanted in the hearts of your servants and for your continued blessings upon them. Give them kind and loving hearts, always ready to ask forgiveness as well as to forgive. Support them through times of trial, strengthen their love for one another, and may that love empower them to be instruments of God's love in the world. This we ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And Todd, would you stand for a blessing, O preacher? If you'd raise your dominant hand toward Todd for a blessing. Todd, we bless you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and we give thanks for your very being, but also for your ministry of word that you have, for the preaching that you will have with us over the next many years, for the wisdom that we will learn from you. May you continue to flourish as a preacher. Amen.
Amen.
And now walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
Eucharistic prayer A is on page 12. The Lord be with you,
and also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and good and joyful, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again, has won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Gracious Father, in your infinite love for us, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Gifts of God for the people of God, all are welcomed at God's table.
Thank you.
Our post-communion prayer is on page 16 of your bulletin or on your screen. Please stand as you're able. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Christ the Lord is
practicing reconnecting with one another and others. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.